Hello guys, my name's Slippery Jack, and today I'm going to be reviewing the new album from Liam Gallagher, Why Me, Why Not? Okay, so Liam Gallagher is a legendary musician out of England, best known as being a pioneer of the Britpop scene and a member of the rock band Oasis. So I know that a lot of you guys are American and you may not have heard much Britpop, but I'm sure that you've heard more than you think. Like, I'm sure most of you have heard Wonderwall by Oasis or Bittersweet Symphony by The Verve. And if you don't recognize the names, I highly encourage you to check them out because both are great songs. But yeah. I love Britpop. I've been wanting to talk about it, and finally I have the chance. And I know that I'm quite late to this review, but whatever. I'm gonna review anyway. Also, I haven't been getting videos up very often. I am sorry about that. I've been being weighed down by lots of schoolwork, and yeah. So uploads are gonna be pretty slow right now, so I'm really sorry, and also you might be able to tell by my voice that I've got some allergies right now. But okay, let's get into it. I'll first talk about Oasis's back catalog. So I will admit that I didn't like this one as much as most people do. I have to be in a certain mood for it, but when I am, it's highly enjoyable, and it's got Live Forever, which is pretty legendary. This is a classic album that you absolutely must hear before you die. Every song on here is amazing. Just go listen to this right now. You will not be disappointed. It's like What's the Story, but more a little more emotional, and the songs are way longer than they have ever been. And I feel that like that's kind of weird because Liam hates it when his songs go on for long periods of time. But whatever, it's a classic album and you must hear this one too. This is a very different one for Oasis. It leans more on psychedelia and uses a lot more electronics, well, for Oasis standards. Many will tell you this is a weaker Oasis album, but ignore them. This is also really great. This one. A lot of Oasis fans will tell you this is one of their weaker albums, but I don't think, yeah, it's not their best. But like, it's not bad either. It's really easy to get into. It's quite predictable, but sometimes I need that. And there's some really good songs on here. Of course, there's none on here that are as good as some of the high moments on Be Here Now or What's the Story, Morning Glory. But as an album, it's very consistent. And how do I explain this? Yeah, there's two Oasis albums that I missed. I'm sorry, but yeah. Moving on. Okay, so as you can tell, I look back on Oasis's back catalog pretty high regards. And so now let's talk a little bit about Liam's last solo album, As You Were. I personally did not find this to be anything special. It was quite forgettable, and compared to other Oasis albums, this was like very lackluster. And the hooks on here were not as good. It's the weakest thing I've seen from Oasis or Liam in general. Maybe it's because I expected it to sound more like Oasis and I didn't really give it much of a chance, but You know, I'll have to go back to it. It might be really good once I come back to it. So when I found out about Why Me, Why Not, I was ready for anything, knowing that, like, I was quite surprised by Liam's last album. I expected an improvement, but at the same time, I wasn't sure. But I was ready. So what did we get with Why Me, Why Not? Well, it was certainly an improvement. A huge improvement, if anything. This album was a lot easier for me to enjoy because it explored territory I was already familiar with. It has that 90s Oasis sound, but it sounds way more fresh because it's being merged with some more modern sounds, especially with styles similar to Arctic Monkeys, Tame Impala, and every now and then Muse. But if you were to ask me, like, who this album sounds like the most, it's definitely Liam's own sound that no one can imitate. And even though all these sounds are familiar, it's all still unique. And there are now orchestras and cool psychedelic effects to make things more interesting. Not to mention, I loved every track. So I'll go down the track listing now. Shockwave, which is the big single. It is a great anthem that really gets you pumped up. And one of us takes the album into a more mellow and emotional direction. It's a lot more melodic, and it's got, like, some really good hooks. And Once has a similar feel to One of Us, but I feel like this one's a lot more memorable, and it sounds more like something like Stand By Me crossed with One of Us. Now That I Found You is a more upbeat love song. I love the harmonies especially, and Halo is a very fun, infectious piano track. I don't know, I just really like it because it's just so much fun to listen to. And at one point there are even recorders that come in which give it like a cheesy kind of feel, and I thought that was pretty cool because, you know, how many big musicians like Liam Gallagher actually do something like that? And then we go into the better part of the album, in my opinion. The title track is an Oasis-style symphonic rock track, and it's got, like, some really addicting melodies, and there's, like, this fuzz guitar that is doing a lot if you listen closely, and, yeah, this is easily, like, one of my favorites. All Right Now really reminds me of the Beatles. It's a very beautiful, comforting, and relaxing, and it's got a guitar solo in the middle that sounds very similar to Tame Impala. And Meadow is just beautiful. It's just like a soft acoustic track, a lot more like the Beatles again, or like a John Lennon solo track. And like, the result is something similar to the psychedelic era of the Beatles, and I just love this. This is another one of my favorites. The River is significantly darker and more harsh sounding, and the lyrics have these cool psychedelic effects that I really liked. And the album ends with Gone, which is a really great ending, in my opinion. The orchestration gives it that really big, expansive feel, but, like, it's also got that angst, and sometimes I'm not in the mood for, like, an album to end on a sadder note, but, like, I would want this removed because this is a freaking great track. But, of course, there's the bonus tracks, and on As You Were, the bonus tracks were the most forgettable and weakest part of the album, but on here, they're every bit as good as the album itself. Invisible Sun has some really cool riffs that made it sound quite epic. And it's not the most memorable on the album, but it really nails its hook. And Misunderstood, Misunderstood is brilliant. It's a very slow, and its lyrics are just beautiful. It's like an encouragement to someone lonely and rejected, and he's telling them, "You're an amazing person. Don't let them get you down. You're just misunderstood." And this song just really touched me, and I can really relate to it. And because of that, it might be my favorite from the entire album. And the final track, Glimmer, sounds a lot like Arctic Monkeys to me. I told that to some people, and they didn't really agree with me, but that's just what it reminded me of. Especially tracks like Fluorescent Adolescent or Marty Bum. And it's very fun and bright, and it's sort of like a continuation of Misunderstood. It's saying, like, there's a glimmer of hope, you're gonna make it. I just love the encouraging lyrics on this album. And overall, Why Me, Why Not is amazing. It has the potential of getting onto my year-end list. I can almost guarantee you, you'll find it on my year-end list. And the vocals are very encouraging. It can really help you through some tough times. And if you are not familiar with Britpop and you would like to hear some of it or get into it, this would be a pretty good starting point. Or if you never could understand Britpop, maybe this will change your mind. And I'm sure, like, Liam enjoyed making this album a lot more. And he even said that, like, As You Were was his favorite album he's ever done, because, like, he doesn't really have to deal with Noel Gallagher and his brother. And yeah, they're very notorious for their fights, and that was the downfall to Oasis, by the way. But yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if this becomes his new favorite. I sure hope it does, at least, but, you know, that's just his opinion. So how does it stand up to Oasis' back catalog? Well, I have to admit, while Why Me, Why Not was enjoyable while it was on, I still enjoy What's the Story, Morning Glory, more, because maybe I've been listening to it longer, but it just really has, like, that it really gives off that 90s Britpop feel way better than this one does. And I don't know, I think it's just a stronger album in my eyes, but it's really not that much stronger, because this was very impressive. But yeah, I still have to prefer What's the Story and Be Here Now, but yeah, it's still a great album. I am overall feeling an 87 out of 100. Thanks very much for watching. Like and subscribe for more entertainment. Make sure you spread the word of this channel. And comment down below what you thought of the album. Did you like it? Did you dislike it? And why? And make sure that you also give me some ideas for what I should review. So that's all for today, and I'll see you next time. Bye.